Pirates, Tigers. Winner of this game takes the series. Both teams 1-1. We won on opening day. Pirates won game two. It's been a very, very pitcher-friendly series. Not much going on in terms of offense to this point. Victor Reyes signing some autographs. And there he is, Ryan Carpenter, 6'5", 210, age 27. Got a nice little bit of hair coming out that cap. That's what I like to see. Now, historically, when pitchers are making their debuts, we don't do very good. We can hope to do better this time. Josh Harrison will lead it off. We have not done well in debuts, and especially with a lefty. I like his delivery, though. It's quick. It's very quick. They were talking about it on the game. The game is going on right now. And they're saying because he's so tall, because he's so big, you know, he tries to streamline his delivery as much as possible to get the ball to home plate quicker. And the stretch delivery is what they came up with to accomplish that. Pirate lineup is Harrison, Frazier, Marte, Corey Dickerson, World Series hero David Freese, followed by Josh Bell, Cervelli, one of my favorite players, Sean Rodriguez. I love him. I love the guy. He will bat eighth, and Gregory Polanco will bat ninth. Here's Adam Frazier. Changing to Pete. It's only 8 o'clock. It is only 8 o'clock. This guy bats really well against lefties for whatever reason. Maybe he just bats really well against everybody. That I'd say that's realistic. It's way colder than that right now. 53 degrees. It's a little bit wishful thinking for Michigan in April 1st. It is now April. On the ground. Should be an easy play for Candelario. Throws across his body, but he does get the out. At first, Adam Frazier's out, and it takes just four pitches to retire the first two Pirates. Good play there by Jamer. And now Starling Marte. I don't mind the lefty on the mound. I don't mind the lefty pitching in this game. Pittsburgh doesn't have a lineup that really favors either side of the plate, so a lefty or a righty shouldn't make a ton of difference. In the air, right field, it'll just take six pitches to retire the Pirates in the first. Easy first inning for Ryan Carpenter. We'll go bottom one. Jacoby Jones will lead us off. Jacoby, we started on opening day. Joe Musgrove. Here is Joe Musgrove. ERA near 5, 7-8 record last year in 15 games. A whip of 1.3. I'm sure he would like that lower, only 98 strikeouts. Looking at the numbers, it looks like we may have a good game, but I said the same thing looking at Trevor Williams, and he absolutely destroyed us. Jacoby Jones did have a hit on opening day. It was 1-for-3. And here's a first pitch curveball. You got more than just that one hat? Oh, yeah. Oh, don't even. I could definitely show you the whole hat collection. But now I got to break this hat in, man. I just got this one. I just got the new Tiger hat for the new year. Got to break this one in as much as possible. I may wear a different one tomorrow. Do I still have my old one sitting around? No. You have multiple teams? Not multiple MLB teams. I have a lot of Tigers caps. A lot of, you know, special event ones. Every year I get the Mother's Day, Father's Day, Memorial Day, 4th of July, All-Star hat. Like, I get those every year. Love them. I get them in 7.5 for the most part, 7 5/8 if I want it to be, like, loose-fitting and comfortable. Taken ball three. Not comfortable, because, you know, 7.5 is comfortable. Fits good, but great patience, and he's just waiting for that pitch that's too good to pass up. 3-1, where's he gonna go? Swinging 3-1 there was a little bit of a mistake. Wasn't really my pitch in my spot, and I shouldn't have been swinging at that. I should have taken the 3-2 count. Mark DeRosa, tell us about this lineup in a daytime. But Joe Musgrove has already almost thrown as many pitches as Ryan Carpenter did in the first inning. John Hicks, Victor Reyes, and Nico Goodrum making their season debut. Cabrera still with no hits. And 0-4 to start the year for Miguel. It'll be Jamer Candelario. I don't know if I pronounce his name one way more than once. I feel like I'm always, it's either Jamer, Candelario. Nobody really knows. I'm just going to go with whatever sounds good at the time. So today I'm feeling Jamer Candelario. 1-0 on Jamer. Oof, changed it up. That pitch looked good. Just fouled it off. It'll be a 1-1 count. Oh yeah, I got so many hats. I have too many. To be frank, I have way too many hats. Hit hard to center. But Starling Marte
to pull it in for route number two.
Is there. I'll flip that onto the cutoff man. Get the ball back into the infield. I actually didn't get that one. I didn't get the players weekend cap because I didn't like it. I didn't like it. The Tigers was like day glow orange, and I just... ugh. I was not a fan. I really... unless I was going to buy a jersey, I really didn't have anything to wear it with. It would have kind of looked stupid.
First pitch of the at-bat. Thought he had the inside.
I don't have a whole lot of orange.
Time, but it missed for ball one.
I mean, it's just, it was, that hat was so bright.
Fly ball out to straight.
Hit hard to right, but right there is Polanco. No, that's not Gregory Polanco. Who are they got in right field today? It is Polanco. He's just wearing high socks. Interesting. No hits for either side in the first. Send Ryan Carpenter back to the mound.
So the next to the plate
and Corey Dickerson.
Corey Dickerson. Get us
he is 0 for 6 to start the new year. It's a good person to hold in check. He's got a lot of power.
He's become known as a starting pitcher that frequently works deep into games. The kind of guy you want on the staff.
Bad timing, really, on the first two pitches in this at-bat.
He tends to eat up innings all by himself.
Well, not a great spot to be in right now. 2-0 to a great hitter like this.
In the air, right field. That'll
really
be...
have to pay
attention. Who did I put in right field today?
And if you have good off-speed stuff,
oh, Castellanos. We didn't take him out.
To start mixing in your off-speed stuff.
For whatever reason, I thought I subbed out Castellanos. So it's Jones in center, Reyes in left. Yep, see, we would have figured that out. There is the defense today. Victor Reyes, Nico Goodrum, and John Hicks. All making their season debuts outside of Ryan Carpenter. Carpenter and Reyes, it's their first major league start.
Settling in now, David.
And here's David Freese.
First pitch on its way. A shot
at
the first baseline.
Just did miss that. Castellanos will have to field it. I don't know if Cabrera dived over that ball. I don't think I reacted quick enough, but let's see here.
Smashed it down the line, and that was some great hustle.
It looks like I was there.
Second to earn himself a double.
But just wasn't able to get the glove down, I think. One out double. Now Josh Bell.
Josh Bell the next to hit. As he looks at a
Jacoby Jones seems like he's been in the league forever. I mean, yeah, a little bit. He's been on the Tigers a couple years now.
Leads off second with one gun in the inning.
Oh, come on.
First baseman.
That one looked like it could easily have gone the other way. There's a big difference between 0-2 and 1-1, but now this next pitch probably becomes the biggest.
Oh, God. Way out in front on that.
A shot hit down the corner, and that nearly broke our score.
Yeah, let's use the curveball. Got a piece. Huh. Swing and a miss. Got him on the changeup. Got him on the changeup. Josh Bell will sit down. And there it is. First major league strikeout for Ryan Carpenter.
Well, Matt, if he can become a consistent strikeout pitcher, you have to figure his career is going to end up being a solid one. All the best pitchers at this level have
ninja or myth.
One pitch.
If we're talking streamers, I have no idea who Myth is, and maybe that's just because If he's a Fortnite streamer as well, then that would explain why I have no idea who he is. Francisco Cervelli. On the ground, should be easy for Machado. Whip this one to first in time, and that'll end the second inning. Top of the second. No runs on a hit here, no errors, Pittsburgh does get a hit, though, in the inning. On now to the bottom of the second, and we are tied nothing-nothing. No, I have nothing against Ninja, really, you know, Fortnite streamers. Y'all do it, what you want to do, but... So, I mean, essentially Ninja, I suppose.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way.
I mean, anyone that can break Twitch with Drake and Juju Smith-Schuster and everyone else, man. You gotta have a good stuff going for you. Oh, good pitch here. Good slider. One on one on Nick. That ball's hit well. Left field, not deep, I don't think. Nope. Ball's just not carrying right now. Waffle King with the follow. Appreciate you. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Francisco Cervelli, one of the best ball framers in all our sport. A guy who's I don't know if I turned the desktop audio up enough in time for that alert to actually sound decent, but there's the Pirates defense.
Next for the Tigers, Victor Martinez.
Well, one out. We need to start taking more pitches. I'm taking this first pitch, that's for sure. Wait till he throws us a strike. Well, spoke too soon. Threw us a strike right there. That was a pretty good pitch to hit, but had already made up our mind that we were going to take it. Off the plate. Victor hit a home run on opening day. Two-run shot that gave us a lead in the first inning after a error on the third baseman that allowed Cabrera to reach. Good ball misses inside. Does not seem too keen on the idea of pitching to Victor here. Missed the game with a curve. 3-1.
Well, this has been a good job to work the count.
See if he gives us one.
3-1, and now he's
it's
really
not in our spot. We're gonna let it go. Slider as well. 3-1 slider. He's got some confidence in that pitch. Got some big time confidence. Does he throw it again here?
Ready. Let's see. To deliver the full count pitch.
Oh, that was a ball. That was a ball. That was ball four. Victor would have been on base. Is that another slider? Nope, that was just a straight fastball. Two outs here in the inning. And John Hicks, second baseman off the glove of Harrison. Hicks will reach, and that's going to go as our first hit.
You know, D-Row, it's not always easy to hit in a day game. First five hitters, five
got our pitch, decided to swing first pitch for once, and drilled that on a line just over the glove. You get a taller second baseman there. That's probably out, but right off the glove of Josh Harrison. And now it'll be the first career at-bat for Victor Reyes. He will bat from the left side. I believe he is a switch hitter. What on earth is Paul's doing? What are we doing here? So Victor Reyes is indeed a switch hitter. Back-to-back switch hitters coming up here in Reyes and Nico Goodrum.
The only thing I was concerned about my first big league AB is if the camera guys could see my leg shaking.
Maybe not a good idea to be swinging first pitch. Should have seen some more pitches with a player that we've not swung the bat with there. A couple mental mistakes early on in this one. But it is still tied at zero. A hit aside in the second. You know, just, I mean, he's throwing a strike, so it's hard to, pass those up. That one with John Hicks, I mean, he gave us that pitch right where we wanted it. And I think I just what I need to tell myself over and over again in my mind is if it's not in the spot that we call it on the first pitch, don't swing at it.
Takes a fastball on the inside corner.
92-mile-per-hour fastball there from Ryan Carpenter. Had to send Buck Farmer down for a game to get Carpenter up here at the major league level. The reason he's up with the big club right now is when you play a doubleheader, you are allowed a 26th roster spot. So obviously we're not playing a doubleheader. Real-life Tigers are. The 1-2. That ball's going to go foul, slicing.
Foul. When you have two strikes on you, as a hitter, if you get something that you can handle...
Swing and a miss. Got through Hicks, but he's able to corral it.
That was a missed opportunity.
And an easy out there. Sean Rodriguez will strike out.
Stepping into the box.
Now Polanco does have a hit in the series. Does not hit lefties very well. But hits righties really, really well. Just everything down and away.
Hey, that's a really
see if he chases this.
Right there, and that's one of those off-balance swings as a pitcher you want to look in and say.
Didn't have to dive for it. Candelario, good throw across the diamond. Two outs.
Gives you a lot of confidence when you make a guy look that bad. So hopefully he has another pitch left.
I mean, the pitcher's duel continues, man. And maybe this is it's the cold weather. It's, you know, first series.
Not much of a problem.
It's cold. Yeah, everyone's cold in more ways than one, but. Right now, no
Josh
bats on either
in.
Side really getting going.
As he'll take a change up here for strike one.
Josh Harrison in the top of the Pittsburgh order will swing around here. Right back up the middle. That will be another hit. Just right back up the middle, little dribbler. And Harrison has the second Pittsburgh hit, if I can use my words properly. Carpenter couldn't get down and field that ball. I like those Pittsburgh socks. They got the bridge on them. Those are nice. Adam Frazier. Gonna have to watch Harrison. Is not stealing, but the slider is low. 1-0 on Frazier.
He's 0-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. The 1-0.
Still not going. 2-0 though. We got it. We got to focus on the batter here.
That's a good approach when you're
got to focus on the batter.
You might not be too familiar with. Take a look at a few and see what he's got. Now he's got himself ahead in the count. Two balls in his strike.
Don't let Harrison bug us too much.
3-1. The count of the Pirates shortstop.
Don't wanna walk him. That pushes a good base runner in Harrison.
I expect a challenge pitch right here.
Rounded to the right.
And it's off the glove of Dixon Machado.
And that'll make it first and second.
Off the glove. Man, he is just... I know that's not an error, but he should get that ball. You make contact. You touch that ball. Field it. That was a difficult play. I know that was deep in the hole, but I really, really would have liked to get that out.
He flew out in his last at bat.
I mean, this is how it happens. You don't take advantage of opportunities to get out of innings. That's how runs get scored. Fastball is in there. Late on it. Didn't chase. What a pitch. Great pitch there, but he did not go after it. 2-2.
Good idea. But I think now he has to
on the ground, 86 speed coming down the line. Machado's got to get that ball out quickly. He does. Hitting over. A couple of base runners for Pittsburgh, but no damage done, man. We got it. We can't be doing that. Cannot be allowing more base runners than we already probably will. Go Tigers is right. Maybe we've converted you.
Digging in the switch hitter, Nico Woodruff.
How does he have an 0.59 average at least? 0-0. Doesn't even make any sense. Was that his average last year? Changeup will miss low.
Now the 1-0.
Wants to play it again. Slider.
Catch the outside.
Not a great spot to be in right here, 2-0, but I'm not so sure why he's pitching this guy so cautiously. A bottom of the
order guy interesting.
You don't normally see getting pitched like this.
Bizarre start to the bottom of the third. Dixon Machado is on deck.
Right
get our pitch we will be taking here all the way. Fastball does indeed find the zone. Goodrum, not a lot of power, I don't think. Only 51. It's enough to hit you some home runs, but... on the ground. Decent pitch. Decent pitch. Maybe a little lower than I would have liked it, but...
Happy to have you along here on the show on a fine Sunday afternoon.
The game's set, but the Royals will start off tomorrow. Then it's on the road for three with the White Sox. An off day mixed in there on Friday. Good to see.
Dixon Machado digs in. He has no
Here's Dixon.
History against this pitcher.
Believe he's the number nine hitter today.
Bat on its way.
Nope.
And that misses ball one.
Zone getting called a little small right now. Got to make Musgrove throw more pitches.
Slider that he looks at over the outside corner.
Austin has more points than you. I'm getting beat right now in our fantasy league. Not a good start for me right now. Oh! Were we late? Yep, sure was.
The 1-2.
On the ground, shortstop. That is... who is that? Is that Jordy Mercer? Is he still on the Pirates? I know he's still on the Pirates. Oh, it's Adam Frazier. I don't think we've seen Jordy Mercer this entire series. Very bizarre. Jacoby Jones stands in. Two outs in the third. There's nothing getting going right now. Musgrove is in a groove. No pun intended. Even if there was a pun intended, it would have been really bad, so forget it happened.
The wind up and the 0-1. And the
change
that is
off
is
the plate.
Way low that time.
I mean, I don't know if he's just not throwing his fastball, because every time I call it, I'm not getting it. Predictable fastball counts, it's just not happening.
Bases are empty here with two men out.
2-1. Give me one, please. Nothing.
Two balls and two
gave us a changeup. We were late on it. It'll be 2-2.
Here now the 2-2. Here's laid off.
I don't know if he just doesn't throw his slider in spots that other pitchers would.
But he just kept his hands back enough.
Got him swinging as he runs the fastball by.
Man, I'm struggling with the bat today.
Digging in to try it again. Corey Dickerson. So far, 0 for 1 with a flyout.
This game is rolling right along as we move into the middle innings with no score.
Good throw there by Dixon.
These two teams would be able to get some base runners on.
Got to get him going in more ways than one. He's got to make all the routine plays. Not drop baseballs. Got to get his bat going. Although we got to get the entire team's bat going.
It was a double for him in his first turn at the plate.
Bad pitch there. David Fries in the batter's box now. On the ground. Should be easy for Candelario. A little bit of a wide throw, but an easy play. That's probably not a bad plan. Not a bad plan at all. Here's Josh Bell with two outs.
First pitch of the at bat. Off the plate and away there. One ball.
I don't know how deep I want to go into the game with Carpenter.
Now the 1-0. Misses for the second.
I'd like to get the bullpen some work today.
Sometimes when you get two quick outs in an inning as a pitcher, you sort of lose focus and let up a bit.
Wow. All right.
Let's see if he can get it back.
3-0 to him now. And
wow. Four straight balls.
For a ball. He walked him. So no 1-2.
Go ahead and
here they've got themselves a two out base runner.
Well, they
get a mound visit just to calm him down.
Take base runners any way they can get him at the very least.
I'm not sure if the new mound visit rule applies to MLB The Show.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Francisco Cervelli comes into this at bat 0 for 1.
I don't see like a mound visit counter. So Chris Bosio will go out and try and calm down Carpenter. His confidence is still pretty good. He's about halfway on energy.
First delivery to him on the way.
It's five straight balls.
Bell is off of first with
no confidence in the fastball. Up the middle.
Bouncer up the middle.
Just get the routine out at first. And that will end the inning. So the two-out walk does not come back to bite us. We got to get the bats going. Bottom four. Here we go. Only one hit. Joe Musgrove has held us in check. But we do have the top of the order, or 2-3-4, rather, batting here.
He'll start things out here in a tie ball game.
By 10? Wait, what? Nah. That ain't right.
Pitch coming, here it is.
And there's one up and in with a fastball there on Jamer. You watch. I will be pronouncing his name differently before this game is over.
And they won't get him to chase.
Good curve there, 2-0.
The dirt that time, and it's 2-0 now.
That was a non-competitive. We gotta make him throw pitches here.
2-0 in this situation. He's going to have to locate 3-0. Something down God. The zone, get himself back in this count.
He's looking a little bit like Carpenter out there. I can't guess pitches today. Maybe this is why. I mean, he's throwing 3-0 changeups. He's just not predictable.
Looking to fade his first walk. Here it comes.
Ball's hit hard, but that's going to go foul by Jamer.
For the right field corner.
See if this even had the distance, even if it was fair. Oh, it looks like it might have. Oh, it stops. It looks like it might have. It would have been close if that ball was fair. Gosh, 3-2. Where does he go? I can't guess him. Fouled away, and we will do it again. When's the last time I guessed a pitch right?
Another full count pitch on its way.
And that is going to be a soft serve. Basket catch by Dickerson. That looked like it was getting down. I mean, I hit the ball hard there, and it's I can't catch a break on offense right now. It's just not going well.
First baseman Miguel Cabrera stands in. He'll look at a breaking
curve ball in the dirt. We got to get Miggy going. He doesn't have a hit yet.
First at bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far.
Although, to be fair, the Tigers as a team right now only have one.
Pitching isn't always about getting
it was a John Hicks single.
Sometimes it's about being smart and knowing when to pick your battles. He's been really careful.
Why?
So far, and rightfully so.
That was a 3-0 count that we just gave up.
Now the 2-1 pitch. It's taken for strike two.
I can't guess this guy because he's not throwing pitches you would try to throw.
If you have the right approach towards that opposite field gap. And this one's tapped foul at home plate. One out, nobody on.
I mean, look at how lucky he's gotten to get two strikes, man. Ball is hit hard left field. That's going
to
get down. Base hit. It's going
to
be a double for Miggy. About time. Extra base hit for Miguel Cabrera, and that is his first hit of the new year.
Ball
was hit well. So a one-out RBI chance here for Nicholas Castellanos. Ooh, Mickey D sounds really good right now. Yep, just out in front on it, off the end of the bat.
Stepping in now, Nicholas Castellanos.
And that's on the ground. And Mayer mailed him. Castellanos is going to go to second on that. Cabrera to third. A throwing error by Moran. Is it Colin Moran? No, it's Sean Rodriguez today. Absolutely sailed that throw over the first baseman's head. He even had some time. Castellanos is not the fastest runner. Wait, what? Who is playing third? Who is playing third today? Oh, that was David Freese. The camera showed Sean Rodriguez. One out. They're going to walk Victor Martinez, I believe, to face Nico Goodrum. First scoring chance that we've had. One hit, one error, one intentional walk have loaded the bases in the fourth. It is John Hicks, who has a hit.
He singled his last time up.
That seems kind of silly.
First pitch of the at bat.
Ball low on Hicks, 1-0. Tigers on all three bags. Not a lot of speed out there. Something's going to have to be hit into the gap. Oof, changed us up. Woohoo! We were way out in front on that ball.
I know he wants that pitch back. He put good wood on that ball. But let's get
actually, we weren't all that far out in front on it. Where did this wind up? Oh, wow. We launched that foul. That almost doesn't make sense. 1-1. Right off the end of the bat, little cue shot foul. 1-2 on Hicks. Where does he go? His best pitch is the slider.
The 1-2.
On the ground, that could be two. On to first, and it is. Man, I should have had that ball, that changeup. I don't know why that was so foul. Can't be doing this either. Bases loaded, one out.
Digging in now.
Cannot do that.
Looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first.
Sean Rodriguez stands in.
Takes a knee-high fastball.
Quickly 0-2 on Rodriguez.
Now 0-2. Two great pitches down in the zone. Interested to see where he goes now. Does he bounce something?
And that got through Hicks. It's going to go all the way to the backstop. And Sean Rodriguez is on base. That'll be a wild pitch right through the legs of Hicks, and maybe that's the disadvantage of having your backup catcher in there. Good pitch to strike him out, but all for naught. Popped him up on really a half swing by Polanco that pulls a mile in the air.
Makes the play, one away.
One gone.
The batter, number five. Digging in and looking for more.
Well, Josh Harrison and the top of the order is lingering. Ooh, that ball, that was a mistake. Did not want that pitch up there. He was out in front on it.
Runner goes for second.
And that's popped up.
Hicks has a play.
John Hicks will catch it. I'll throw it on to first just to make sure that he's not going anywhere. And now Adam Frazier, two out, one on. Slider will miss.
That one stayed too low, apparently.
Up the middle, that is going to be a base hit. Runner will not advance to third, stops at second.
You never want to beat a pitcher that
two on, two out.
This guy was too good. You knew it was a matter.
Right back up the middle. We've allowed a lot of hits. Just slow rollers up the middle. I don't know if we need to play our middle infielders more shaded towards center. Oh, this one might end the inning. Cabrera over to get it, and it does. So Pittsburgh will strand runners as well. Neither offense is good right now. No. The pitching staff has been for both teams. Here's Victor Reyes. See a few more pitches with him this time.
Victor Reyes. First pitch on its way.
I mean, Musgrove is just so unpredictable tonight.
Been a great story in the baseball world lately.
Oh, here we go.
Taken some major strides since his early days.
That is up the middle, base hit. There we go. First major league hit for Victor Reyes. And a guy with some speed is on base. We finally guessed a pitch. Been waiting for that all night. Hey, look at this. Cabrera's coming out to get the baseball, looks like.
The ball being sent into the dugout. Someone will tuck it away for him to put in his trophy case.
Yeah, good for him.
You allowed to request a song when you have an intermission? I don't know if I have. Let me. I got to pull Nightbot out if we're going to do
that. Inside his head, he's on top of the world.
Now you can you can try.
Standing in now, Nico Goodrum.
They pitch out. Pitch out here, expecting a steal there.
Reyes on at first, nobody out.
Might consider it.
That's
2-0.
Wide, 2-0.
On the ground's gonna be another double play, isn't it? Nope, a lob throw onto first. Nico Goodrum safe.
That's a really tough double play to turn with the first baseman.
Some speedy guys on base broke that one up. Ray is out at second. But a little bit of a lob here from Adam Frazier. He didn't really fire that ball. I think Goodrum might have been safe anyway. We cannot hit with runners on base right now. Neither team can.
From the stretch, here's the pitch. And he'll try to hold back the swing, but he'll do so unsuccessfully.
I gotta call that a strike. I wanna see it. I know it was probably close. Oh yeah, we went around. Oh yeah.
Has a look now. The pitch.
Oh my gosh.
And this one's in the dirt.
How were we fooled that badly? I mean, 79 on a changeup is ridiculously slow.
Pause, now the pitch.
On the ground, and this is going to be the double play. They didn't miss their shot the second time, and how many are we going to ground into tonight?
Ready once again, Corey Dickerson. No hits to this point.
Left fielder.
First delivery to him on the way.
And the slider. I want to get somebody up in the bullpen. I don't want to push Carpenter farther than he can go.
Good slugger up at the plate. This is the time as a pitcher you have to really make
nobody
some
with
pitches.
Decent stamina.
This is not
shit.
The time to just groove one right down the middle.
All
right.
Well, let's keep him in for at least the 1-0. Sixth. If we can.
And this is fouled at the plate.
I just feel like the Pirates sooner or later are gonna catch up to him.
One home. Bounces in the dirt for a ball.
What do I gotta do? I'm timing these up. Let's go.
This team has been struggling offensively, but here's a perfect situation with a 3-1 count. You have a chance to do some damage. You know.
I mean, his fastball has not been a good pitch tonight.
Now the 3-2 pitch.
There it was. Finally. Frazier is down.
Oh man, he's been absolutely getting overmatched at the plate the last couple of games.
Here is David Freeze.
In this series alone. So clearly this pitching staff, they figured out how to attack this guy. We'll see if he can make any adjustments.
Not a good spot there. Don't want to throw it there intentionally too many times. On the ground. Easy play for Dixon.
And that's the second out.
Well, at least we're getting something going on one side. Our pitching has been solid all day, all series, but
digging in once again, Josh Bell. It was a walk in his last trip. And he lays off.
It's been a bad series for the bats. We're gonna have to fix that as we get into this Kansas City series. Under the glove of Candelario, that's gonna be a hit for Josh Bell. Fifth hit for Pittsburgh.
He looked a little bit out in front right there, but he's
way out in front on it. And again, I mean, I'm diving on these. I'm just not getting a glove to him. Candelario, I thought, was there. I don't know if he dove over it. He just didn't get down. Didn't get down in time. Two outs.
Here's the catcher, Francisco Cervelli.
It'll be Cervelli.
Strike at the knees. It's 0-1. He's 0-2 in the ballgame so far.
Oh, caught by Candelaria. He made up for it. Good play by Candy. And he'll bat. He'll bat second in the inning, top of the order. Coming up. Gotta get something going here, man. We got it. This has been just an awful series with the bats. I know it's the first series of the year, but man, I don't know where he's throwing this slider. I don't know. I mean, he's been really, really good today.
Filling up the strike zone all the time, every inning. He's pitching well as we're moving into the middle innings.
You would think sliders away from the right-handers makes sense if you're a right-handed pitcher. I mean, but he's just not throwing it. Oh, right as I say that. And when he does, it goes to the backstop.
Well, that's a good pitch, but you have to get a little bit closer to the plate than that. That's that big sweeping slider. If it was a little closer, you might
in the air for Jones, but that'll be caught by Polanco.
Under this one is Polanco, and he's got it for the first out.
Now batting, third baseman.
No consistent offense right now.
Next up for Detroit.
We'll get the switch hitter Candelario in here.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes.
Curveball down. Not a lot of velocity on Joe Musgrove, and maybe that's why we're struggling like we are.
The 1-0 home. Hit on the ground down
not
the
in front
first
on that.
Line, but a foul ball, 1-1.
I mean, 92 on the fastball. That's not all that fast.
No offer.
Went with the sinker.
And
really, he's been a five-pitch pitcher, but he's really limited himself to about three pitches. He hasn't thrown the curve all that much. And when he does, he's not very good with it. And then the sinker, he's hardly used at all.
Into the windup. Here's the 2-1 pitch. High in the air.
In the air, Candelario driving Starling Marte back. But it will stay in the spacious outfield of Comerica Park. 70 pitches now for Musgrove with two outs here in the sixth. Miggy finally got his first hit of the year. His last time up, a double down the line. I take his first home run of the year right here.
He's ready. Here's the first offering.
Be lovely.
Here to start the at bat. It's 1-0. The 1-0.
Up the middle. Wow, just did miss Joe Musgrove. Miguel Cabrera with his second hit of the game. It'll be up to Nicholas Castellanos.
The right fielder, number 9, Nick Castellanos.
Nick Castellanos now.
Who has also gotten off to a cold start. Our hot bats, or our big bats, are not getting off to a very good start here in this season.
First pitch coming, here it is.
Changeup. Man, that's so slow. 80 miles an hour.
Well, that was a big two-out single we just saw, and for pretty obvious reasons. The inning went from totally under control to now. He's got to deal with
in
some
the air.
Dangerous hitters here with a
right
runner
field.
On base, and this is how
not
two-out
deep.
Rallies start.
And he'll get there in plenty
of I'm so sick of these pitcher's duels.
We are still scoreless.
I want runs. We need more runs.
Back here,
line scored through six.
Neither team denting the run column quite yet.
It's gonna. It might be first to one. First run might win this game.
So the next to the plate for
five hits and error for the Pirates. Four hits, no errors. For Detroit.
Oh, that's one of
and I mean his pitch count, Carpenter's pitch count is in great shape. I mean, so if he continues to have success, especially because he's going to get sent back down to the minors after this game, I mean, then let's just keep him in.
Tried to go with the nasty backdoor breaking ball right there. Good job by the batter to take that pitch, work the count.
But second he gets into trouble here,
Machado,
I don't know how comfortable we should be with him in the game.
Man is gone here to start inning number 7.
Right fielder, Gregory Polanco.
Dixon's made the routine plays today, which is good to see.
Gregory Polanco, he was retired after popping out in his last at bat.
On the ground, dropped by Carpenter. The throw, a little bit high, but got him. Good recovery. Kind of a bizarre play. Now Harrison. Top of the order, I believe this is the fourth time through the lineup. By Cabrera. Harrison is on base again. We've held really the entire lineup in check for the most part in this series, but Harrison's coming alive today. And nobody on the hot corners have been able to make plays today. They've been not been able to keep balls in front of them. Adam Frazier will look at a changeup in there for a strike. Getting tired is Carpenter. Oh, down the line, Candelario didn't move. Reyes will barehand it. Two on, two out, and it's going to be a mound visit and a bullpen. Pitcher will get up here. I mean, that pitch is out of the zone. Frazier just takes it the other way. And Candelario was playing off the line, and then he didn't move. I thought maybe if we backtracked a little bit, he might have had a chance to get that ball. The only pitcher I'd like to stay away from today is Joe Jimenez. Seventh inning, we can warm up Alex Wilson. If we don't use him in this inning, we can use him next inning. Starling Marte. Changeup misses inside. He's got to get That's going to get a run in. That is going to get a run in. It is 1-0 Pittsburgh. Just a bloop. All the offensive struggles in this series and a weak hit like that has put the Pirates up by one. Well, we need a mound visit right now. We need Alex Wilson ready yesterday. He's not ready yet.
Slow yourself down enough to come through, and that's exactly what he did. Looking to keep this a one-run game.
Change up elevated. I mean, he's losing command of his stuff.
And Dickerson behind 0-2 now.
We got to go to the seldom used curve here and hope Hicks can block it.
Let's see if he can battle.
He did. Wasn't far enough away to let the other runs score. And that's going to be a base hit. That might get two runs in. Throw home. It's going to nail. No, it didn't get Marte.
Now a 3-0 ball game. Hey, Dero, that's a big
Corey Dickerson drives in two, and we had him. What happened? He didn't get the tag.
What you're trying to do is put your pitchers in positions to be successful. Giving them that three-run cushion has to make.
That's got
to
be it for Carpenter. Alex Wilson's going to have to come in earlier than I wanted him to.
Fatigue could very well become a factor at some point. Yeah, that's always a tough question to answer for a manager, especially when your guys still pitch you well.
I mean, we've been
starting to get hit more.
Oh, what a play by Victor Reyes. All right, a bright spot in the inning. Sliding play. Ugh. Could have used that three batters ago. All of a sudden, there's 9 hits for Pittsburgh. And our offense has got to get it going and got to get it going now. It is still Joe Musgrove. I mean, I can't do anything with that curveball. I'm just going
to
pop it up.
One-on-one. Lifted the other way.
Come on, get down.
Center.
Get down.
And that's the first out of the inning.
Even when I'm just, the bloops are falling for them. The line drives are falling for them. They're not falling for us. What? I can't do anything.
Ready for another shot now. John Hicks.
I mean, that's what's frustrating is that, you know, we're hitting the same balls that they are. Our offense is struggling just like theirs. And that last inning, they're falling. I'm on top of that. Going to be an out.
There are
I mean, our offense is just non-existent.
The left fielder, number 20,
stepping in.
I mean, I'm out in front on that, trying to pull that ball, and it's just on the ground.
Oh, there's definitely some diamonds that fall through the cracks, and this is obviously one of them. You root for guys like this.
Victor Reyes did get a single his last time up. Need about a home run out of him here.
Fastball down near the shoe tops. Hold high in the air out to right.
Come on!
Harrison is there. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. Down in order go the Tigers. They trail it here 3-0. Josh Bell the next to hit. Pass numbers against Alex Wilson. Not a big sample size, 0-for-1. Tough slider that just catches the corner for a strike. Right there, and it's quickly 0-2.
I don't get it.
Nothing in two count, and the pitch.
That's going to get, no, it's going to go foul. A hook on that ball to get it out of play. I just.
The next 0-2.
Input lag got me there. I hit the button, nothing happened. Hit it again, all of a sudden I'm throwing the pitch. MLB's always had that problem.
Oh, a fastball swung on and missed.
Could have used a few of those strikeouts earlier in the game.
At the plate, Francisco Cervelli.
I mean, we held them in check.
First offering on its way.
All game.
And he's in front of a tight.
All of a sudden they dot us up.
And that one just missed outside. The 1-1 pitch. Right side.
Ah, just out of the reach of Dixon. Come on! We're grounding out right to their fielders, and they're finding holes. I mean, it's just, are we playing the wrong defensive shifts, or what's going on here? I mean, oh, come on! Now you're going to do that? No!
Now as he looks at a ball,
that's a strike.
Base runner at first with one out.
Yeah, how about that? It's in the same damn spot. Look at that.
In the
only 33 speed. He's not gonna go.
Runner holds as the count moves to 2-1. He's running.
And it's a hit and run, and because of that, we might have a chance at third. Because of the hit and run, the second baseman is then standing on second. That leaves the hole wide open. You could not draw, you couldn't throw it better.
You don't see it in today's game too much. There's a lot of moving parts, a lot of walks, homers, and strikeouts.
That's exactly where he needed to hit that ball, and that's exactly where it went. You have got to be kidding me.
Offering. Nope. Missed with a slider. You could tell he's
I mean, it's just
stupid. Knocked around the yard a little bit, and you can tell he's starting to feel for it. One ball, one strike to count.
I'm timing these up. Hit the target, please.
As a hitter, to be aggressive, you can pretty much count on a pitcher. He's trying to get back in the strike zone, and with two guys on base right here, it's time to.
You know, that's what sucks about this game sometimes, and just the game of baseball in general. You know, I'm doing what I can, and I'm just not getting the results.
Swing and a little tapper. That's a foul ball. Back-to-back breaking balls. He just missed that one right there, fouling it away. Do not expect a third. Lifted.
Please, give me something today. Everything is going their way. And now he's going to foul pitches off on me, and we're going to be here in eternity.
Locked in a good battle. Here comes another one.
Can you either strike out or put something in play? I don't care which one at this point.
He's going to miss over the heart of the plate at some point. 3-2, full count. Hit hard on the ground to second.
Throw the ball! He got one. They're unscored. Don't just stand there like this. Hey, let me just stand here for a second before I throw the ball. What are you doing? Throw it quicker. If you throw the ball quick, we have a chance to get two.
On a single in his last time up. Hit on the ground to short.
Gotta get this ball out quick. None of your dilly-dallying this time. Throw the ball. Eighth inning, all of a sudden we're down four. Joe Musgrove is still in the game, a.k.a. Jesus Christ. I've never been shut down by such a bum. I mean, why am I late there? Why?
And he lays off the pitch down and away, ball two. Into the windup, here's the 2-1 pitch.
Swung Nico Goodrum.
Right, and no doubt about it. And goodbye, this one ain't coming.
Doesn't even. It's hard to get me excited because we're still down three, but I mean, it's good to be on the board. First career home run for Nico Goodrum is an absolute no doubter. I mean, that's. I've been out in front on balls all day. They've been pulled foul. This ball was crushed to right field. It was an absolute no-doubter about five rows up. Oh, and he's getting the silent treatment. The boys don't want to talk to him. And that'll be all for Musgrove. So we are going to get into the Pirates' bullpen. But 7 1/3 for Joe Musgrove. He absolutely shut us down today. We didn't help ourselves out. Bases loaded there mid-innings. I don't remember what inning it was, and we didn't get anything going. Honest Kevin Segrist. One inning, one strikeout. Did not allow a run in his opportunity, or a hit, actually. Against us the other day in their closer, Francisco Felipe Rivero is also warming up. Well, it's going to take a lot more than a solo shot to get us back in this game. And he can't throw his fastball for a strike. That is 2-0.
The 2-0 on the way.
On the ground. Of course he's got it played perfectly. Machado is out. Actually, it was seven innings straight for Joe Musgrove, as I would have figured out just now. That's the first out here in this inning. 85 pitches. We didn't do a good job of running his pitch count up either. And I mean, we were putting balls in play. We only had one strikeout.
One run in and one gone so far this inning. First pitch coming. Here it is.
Top of the order, Jacoby Jones. Could be the last time the heart of the order sees the plate today, so we got to get these guys. Oh, God, what a pitch. Whoa, what a pitch. Oh, I called the right one here. Late on it. So, I mean, he's got more on these pitches than Musgrove did all day, so it's really kind of hard to guess. Hit it hard, left field. Jacoby Jones back. He's hit it out. Two home runs in the eighth, and just like that, we're only down two. Well, okay. First home run for Jacoby Jones. First home run for Nico Goodrum. And now it's the 2-3-4 hitters. Candelario, Cabrera, Castellanos. Elevated fastball does just fine the bullpen. And now it's some guys that can really hit.
The next batter, Jamer Candelario.
Changeup will miss.
Pitch here that misses for ball one. Now the 1-0.
Ooh, no! Why did I miss it? Early, yes! It means I should... Oh, that means I should be on it. Well, that ball's in the gap. Oh, Marte ran it down. The all-star center fielder for the Pirates, Starling Marte, is running down our gappers now. Well, let's see if Miggy can get one here. Ah, what am I doing? That was such a mistake.
He's got over 400 of them in his career.
Oh, what? I timed it up perfect. No. Don't be surprised. Just swung under it. Trying to get chase there, but it's I'm so bitter.
This is one of those classic cases of the right guy at the right spot. They need to get a rally going, and this is maybe their best
throw ball in the dirt. The right guy in he the doesn't right want to throw anything in the zone right now to Cabrera.
Two balls and two strikes.
That ball is hit deep to left. If it stays fair, it's going to go, but it's foul. We almost had our third home run of the inning. That will be soft serve right field in for a base hit. And this inning will not end. Nick Castellanos will stand in now. Kevin Segrist has not gotten the job done. He's allowed a home run and now a base hit to Cabrera. Man, the more we can get done now. I was about to say before Felipe Rivero comes in, but here he is. This guy's a flamethrower. He will be asked to get a four-out save. And Nick Castellanos, whose batting average is down below 100.
Nick Castellanos now.
Fastball is downstairs at 98 miles an hour. Shane Green is up and ready. Should we tie this game? Inside with a changeup at 89. 2-0. Where does Rivera go here?
Now the 2-0.
And that is going to be a base hit. Two on, two out here for Victor Martinez. Well, now the go-ahead run will come to the plate. It took till late in this game, but both offenses finally starting to click, and they will rip Rivero out after one pitch for George Contos. Their best reliever out, and they bring in Contos. I don't understand that decision. So Victor will bat from the left side.
Switch hitting Victor Martinez.
Oh.
So go after the first pitch and bounce it into
a little bit out in front on it. Just a little.
Ready with the 0-1.
Inside with the cutter, elevated 87 miles an hour. Even a base hit to cut this to a one-run game would be huge. Ball is hit well, but right at the left fielder, Dickerson, to end the inning. Two home runs, one by Nico Goodrum, one by Jacoby Jones, have made this a game again. And all of a sudden, the pitcher's duel has turned into an offensive showcase. 19 hits between the two teams. What is going on? Adam Frazier is 3-for-4. And I am going to bring in, I don't want to bring in Shane Green, but I have to. Do not have a choice. Do not have another reliever. Alex Wilson was running out of energy. So we'll bring in Green, but we'll also get, let's see. I don't want to work Jimenez. Let's get Drew Verhagen up. Because I don't want to use Green a ton. Still want him available if we get him in a good situation for tomorrow's game.
And
This one's downstairs. It's a ball and a strike.
One and one.
The 1-1 home.
In the air, shallow center. That'll be Nico Goodrum. Outfield,
one down.
Center fielder number six, Darling.
What, it'll be 6-7-8 due up for the Tigers in the ninth inning.
Comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day.
We do have some
first pitch of the at-bat.
Decent hitters on the bench that we can go to.
Right-hander, as this is a ball 1-0. The 1-0 home.
Shane Green can't find the strike zone. 2-0 to Marte.
Back-to-back pitches, they've gone away. Do you tell yourself as a hitter he wants to come in right here? I don't think so.
Popped him
I
up.
Think he's trying to find that.
Perhaps a little fortunate there.
And they're to bring it two out. Cabrera for out number two.
Now batter, left fielder Corey Dickerson.
Just no
stepping in.
No offensive consistency just yet.
Dickerson. In his last appearance, he singled home a pair of runs.
Slider will miss inside.
Good late break to the
who
slider.
Is who's on deck?
On the hands for ball
David
one.
Freeze. I'd really rather face David Freeze, but I'm not going to intentionally walk him. I am going to attempt to pitch to him, but I'm not going to give Dickerson anything to crush here. Yeah.
And a 2-0 fastball runs
it
away.
Is what it is on this one. I'd rather face David Freeze. I didn't even want to give him that.
Two out, nobody.
One of that down and in.
And
there it
is.
Ball four to Dickerson. It'll be a two-out walk for Green, and now David Freeze.
Head-to-head battles with Shane Green. He's 2-for-3.
I'd rather have Freeze in as a right-handed bat. Blue, give it to me. That's a strike.
Not going his way right there has anything to do with walking the last guy. We all know umpires don't give you much on the.
And that should have been strike three.
Throwing strikes consistently.
And he struck him out. So a good pitch.
Just took one extra pitch, I guess. We'll go to the bottom of the ninth. It'll take two runs to tie, three to win it. Let's see who the Pirates trot out there. They've already used their closer. They won't make a pitching change. It will still be Contos. It is John Hicks. Let me see, actually. Does Hicks hit better than McCann? Hicks is a better hitter against righties than James McCann is. So, I'm going to take that. What is this delivery right now? That was weird.
Ready. Here's the first offering.
Out in front of the cut. I was geared up for Rivero, and I just haven't slowed myself back down. Popped up.
Swing and a high pop up.
That's again just not getting the results. I think I was on that pitch just underneath it. One out in the ninth. Bit unfortunate. It is Victor Reyes.
For the fourth time in his career, having already collected his first hit. Not a bad first day, huh?
Oh, we just crushed that ball, but it's foul.
Fail when they invest minimal money
right off the end of the bat.
It shows how hard this guy has had to work to grind through the minor leagues and get to this point.
In the air, center field.
Harrison.
Josh Harrison will find that one, and there are two down. Down to our final out. Pirates looking to take the opening series. Going to drop the record for our Tigers down to 1-2.
And he needs to make something happen. They're down to their final.
Nico Goodrum is our last chance.
The last at-bat, Matty D. We heard this guy's a good fastball hitter. He got a fastball and didn't.
Did hit a home run in the eighth inning.
A little bit differently this time.
What if two home runs in the frame?
0-1 count. Here's the pitch.
1-1. We just need a base runner. And then probably bring in a pinch hitter for Dixon Machado if it gets that far. Two and one.
Runs a little too far in ball two.
A base hit. We do get our base runner. Nico Goodrum with two hits in the game.
That fires me up right there. What a clutch AB, a two-out single.
All right. Well, we're not out of it. Who can we bring in off the bench that's going to have a little bit more power, some home run power? Unlike Dixon Machado.
Yeah, Matt, I kind of doubt he's thinking about going yard, even though...
Not a lot of power versus righties, but Mikey Matuk is going to be our best shot. I trust Mikey's bat much more than I trust Dixon's. If anything, to get a ball in the gap. Mikey Matuk. Borderline pitches going the ways of the Pirates again. Big hole on the right side. Up the middle. Will be a flip. No, he didn't flip it on to second. He does make the throw to first, but that gets Matuk, and Joe Musgrove led the Pirates to victory today. Man, did he shut our offense down. As soon as he left the game, our offense came alive. Oh, boy, and it is a series, season-opening series loss. We will end the three-game set with the Pirates with one win and two losses. We had more success against Jameson Taillon than we had against guys like Joe Musgrove and Trevor Williams. All of the runs scored on the final three frames. 4-2 is the final score. That sucks. That really does suck. I felt like we deserved better, but then again, you strand bases loaded with one out. You ground into a double play with the bases loaded. You deserve to lose. End up with 20 combined hits between the two teams. That's better than I expected. Oh, boy. Oh, whoop, that's not what I wanted. This Nico Goodrum homer, let's actually take a look at this. Take a look at this again. Best swing we put on a ball today. And there it goes. It really was a no-doubter. Whoop. Can you work? Can you work, camera? I'm pushing the down button and it's going up. Not really sure I understand that. What on earth is that about? What is that? What are we doing here? Come on. This replay system is the jankiest thing. Seriously, your replay system is garbage. You have to go left to go right. What is this? This is the jankiest. Can we move? Can we move here? That looks so weird. All right, Nico. Sorry, it's not you, but it is you. Let's find Ryan Carpenter. There we go. Solid. What do we want to do? What do we want to do? I still got like an hour if I so choose to stream. Anyone here? No, not really. We'll wrap it up after that. Shitty game. This wasn't a good game. We never got anything going at bat. We never got anything going at the plate. I mean, it's just nothing. Nothing at all. So we will regroup for the start of a three-game set with the Kansas City Royals right now. Actually, this rotation will be different. It'll be Francisco Liriano, probably Jordan Zimmermann, honestly, and then it could be Michael Fulmer there in the second game or the final game of the series. And the greatest thing that I think that I've seen here is that we don't have to face Ian Kennedy at the moment. Right now, it is Jesse Hahn, Nate Carnes, and Danny Duffy, who is the supposed ace of the Royals, but he only pitched 2 1/3 innings. What happened to the Royals on opening day? They got shelled. What happened? 6 first inning runs. All right. I mean, I'll take that if we can get that on Danny Duffy. Carnes and Hahn will be making their first starts of the year. I'll take that. Anyway, I will see you guys tomorrow. Don't know how long of a stream I'm really going to be planning to do, but can't expect Tigers franchise to be tomorrow. I mean, I've learned my lesson with that. You know, falling behind in that series just makes it impossible. 7,000 drop frame. When did that happen? 7,000. Oh, my God. Charter, you guys are the worst internet service provider on the planet. Oh, my Lord. Whatever. Peace out. Have a good rest of Easter. Take care. See you tomorrow.